and the year, brothers and sisters in Christ. Let us turn to our Holy Bible to Matthew chapter 8. Today's scripture reading is from verses 23 to 27. Jesus calms the storm. Then he got into the boat and his disciples followed him. Without warning, a furious storm came upon on the lake, so that the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us. We are going to drown." He replied, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, "What kind of man is this, given the winds and the waves obey him?" This is the word of God, written for the people of God.
Just like sea. like now. But actually it was not very big, only about 20 kilometers long, and only about 10 kilometers wide. But the wind would be very powerful, and the wind would sink boat, and very often. And so when Jesus stood up, he rebuked the wind. He spoke angrily, maybe strongly. Maybe he said, "Stop, wind." And in the sea, he said, "Be calm." And the Bible tells us it became like the sea, like a glass of sea, very calm. My friends, you know, when I read about the Sea of Galilee, sometimes I remember then I go by Tobolate. There are differences, you know. Tobolate is 1,000 meters above sea level. Because if you go to the October, you go up, getting higher. And of course, at Ram, you go down. But all in all, the surface of Tobolate is about 1,000 meters above sea level. But the Sea of Galilee or Lake Galilee is about 600 feet, well, you can say 200 meters below sea level, not above sea level, below sea level. And you know what? It's not safe. The winds are very powerful because, you know, the valley is very deep. It's like cleft by the Jordan River, very deep. And the wind would come from the west, from the Mediterranean Sea, and would blow very powerfully and would sink many boats in those places. Very sudden. I read that sometimes, you know, this Lake Galilee would be very calm for a while. Suddenly the wind would come. It could sink your boat. So when you think of India, think about what we have read. Life is like that. Sometimes life is calm, very calm. But suddenly something wrong happens. Like a mighty wind. It can happen. Life is like that. When it is good, we can enjoy. And we must praise God when it's good. Some people think, life is good. No problem. They just forget about God. And then when there is a storm of life coming, then they begin to cry and shout, asking for help. We should always ask God to help us. You see, life is like sailing. We don't know what happens. We don't know what happens tomorrow. Especially in the last week, two of my friends that I know, four people like that. Now I think that I have no way. Oh, way. And died. Professor Sintola, you know, died. He went to the funeral yesterday. Only 80 years old. For us, 80 years old is very old. But for me, 80 years old, I can say still 80. You know the difference? Because I was old. Still 80. Did I? Yes, life is like that. And Martina's father passed away. I was told by Martina that actually her father was not sick. Became sick, he was hospitalized. Yeah. We don't know. Suddenly the wind comes and can be very powerful. There are a lot of problems, my friends. I still teach at the university, and sometimes my students take to me, you know, telling me about their problems. Recently, most students. kids from here, told me that they were going home because, you know, plantation is not working because palm oil is getting less because of the fire in Rio. Suddenly the fire came, burned all plantations. When students had to go home, like the wind, like wind coming, the wind of economic difficulty. What is the wind of family conflict? It comes suddenly. I hope it will not come to us. But there are many marriage conflicts coming up very suddenly. Last year we have celebrated the wedding of a family member. And 3 years ago, three days ago, we went to a certain party and we met there. And he told me that his wife had left him with a baby. I felt very sad, just like a mighty wind striking the family. Marriage problem, health problem also, health. Sometimes we feel very healthy. Very nice. Suddenly, they become sick. Sometimes what happens, my dear friends? Economic problems, I already mentioned that. Who can control these economic problems? We pray to God so that our economy will continue to be nice and smooth. But we don't always know what can happen. When we see these political problems nowadays around the world, I just read in the newspaper during the last year, 2015, more than 1,500,000 people, refugees from the Middle East and North Africa, went to Europe. We don't know what they're going to do in Europe. Germany, Italy and all other countries, refugees. And you know how many people? 350,000 died on the way, perished before they reached Europe. So there are winds of difficulties, winds of problems that come down suddenly. Wind of sorrow, maybe the last one. Death can come suddenly. You know, sometimes, you know, I'm old. Sometimes I don't realize I'm very old. For the Bata people, you know, if a person is old, he begins to think about death. And he thinks about when I die, what will happen? Where will the people be? Yeah, well, Bata, you know, if a Bata person dies, what will happen? When they have to build up, like, roofs and so on. Well, you can say, well, don't think about that, Reverend. But who knows? Nobody knows. Our life is in the hand of God. My dear friends, the topic of our sermon is God and our future. No matter what happens, even though the wind may be strong, even though the storm may come, but don't forget, Jesus is there. Jesus is there. Like what happened to the disciples? Even though the disciples were very afraid, they remembered that Jesus was there, that there was something good in there, but they went to wake him up. Wake up, Lord, wake up, Lord. There is a storm coming. Wake up, help us. We are going to perish. Perish. You don't say perish. Perish. And you know what he said? You men of little faith. See, when we are afraid, what we need? Faith in the Lord through Jesus Christ. If we have faith in the Lord through Jesus Christ, then our fear disappears. That's it. That's what Jesus was saying. You men of little faith. Maybe Jesus can also say to us, or to me, maybe to me, you men of little faith. I will be there. Just call upon the Lord in my name.
I will stop the wind. I will calm the sea. See? I will calm the sea. And he did it to the disciples. In front of the disciples, he did it. He stood and he said, wind stop, and sea be calm. And the Bible tells us the sea became dead calm. Amen. Calm, everything is calm. So, there is God in our future, he promised. Our life can be calm. Now, when we say, the worst thing is sailing at night. You know that? Sailing at night. Two boys told me about their experience in Global Lake. They were rowing a boat. You know why they rowed the boat from Bakara to Nuara at night? They were rowing. You know, sometimes life is not like sailing. Life is like rowing, struggling for life, you know, making a living. And these two boys were safe. They rowed all the way from Bakara to Nuara. And one time they said at night, the boat, a big boat from the market from Bolivia, was sailing to Bakara. And they were afraid of the waves. The waves were very high. And they had no lantern. So they tried to sail a bit far and they were safe. The most difficult time to sail is at night. We don't see what is ahead of us. Life is like that. Sometimes we are living as if we were sailing at night. We don't see what is ahead of us. We don't know what will happen tomorrow. We don't know what will happen the day after tomorrow. We don't know what will happen next year. But let us remember that Jesus is there. And all we have to do is call him. Oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus, save us, guide us, lead us, give us calm. The Lord will be there. We have experienced that, my dear friends. I think I have had more experience than you all. I experienced difficulties during the war when the Japanese came. There was nothing, my friends. No food, no transportation during the Japanese time. And I had to walk for many, many miles, many times. But I always call upon God in the name of Jesus. And you see, I'm still alive. And I know that God is real. Call the name of God. See, that's it. We call the name of God. God, in the name of Jesus. Through Jesus Christ, I come to you, God. Guide me, lead me. Whatever evil may happen to us, that's what we do. I have already told you about, you know, the people who were possessed. Possessed. In English, if a person is possessed, in Indonesian, you say, kesurupan. Life can be like possessed sometimes. We are in trouble. But remember, if someone is possessed, don't call dukun. You know, in Indonesian, dukun, what is dukun in Indonesian? There is no other name. But in English, what? In English, you can call it witch doctor. Wow. Dukun is a doctor. But witch doctor? Witch. So if there is someone who is possessed, don't call witch doctor, my dear friends. Call God in the name of Jesus. Let's see. Call God in the name of Jesus. And if you hear a voice shouting, don't say, who are you? Don't say, who are you? That is wrong. Just call God in the name of Jesus. Ask God to send this noisy person. I call it noisy. Noisy person. To its own place. I never ask, what is your name? If I ask what's your name, he might say, I am your father. What happened, my friend? Whoa, that took me in trouble. How can I say, God, send this noisy person away? How can I say? So I never say, who is your name? That is the secret. Some people ask me, who are you? You say, I am the one who died beside the river. My body was eaten by a crocodile. That is wrong. There are no questions to ask. Don't ask the question. So you see, my friend, just call God in the name of Jesus. And the Lord will quiet everything. Lead us. God is our future. No matter what happens in the future, through the power, final power, no matter what happens. Let me just read in closing what Peter, a religious writer, wrote. Just one verse. Peter, I know not what the future hath had the word translated. I know not what the future hath of marvel or surprise. Assure the Lord that life and death, God's mercy and the rise. No matter what happens, God's mercy is there to hold us, to keep us safe, and to take us home safe. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father God, in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, we praise you, Lord. You honor you and glorify you. Thank you, Lord, for the message. For no matter what happens, we know that you are there and we call upon you in the name of Jesus. And the sea which is hard can become calm, and the wind that is mighty, the threatening, can become very calm, smooth. Bless us, Lord, guys. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.